Today we have a chance to stop and remember the men and women of our Canadian Armed Forces. They have sacrificed their time from their families, put themselves in harm's way, and have even given up their lives. Our armed forces fight for our rights and freedoms every day and have done so since we became a country. They continue to serve and fight for our way of life, helping many countries around the world. Many of us do not know anyone who has served. However, their impact on our daily lives means we can move freely in and out of the country, practice our religion, and have our democratic voice heard through voting. Many Canadian soldiers have been injured, and many have died to protect our way of life, a life that we, at times, take for granted. This is why today, on Remembrance Day, we stop. This is why we remember.
There's no one in town I know. You gave us some place to go. I never said thank you for that. I thought I might get one more chance. What would you think of me now? So lucky, so strong, so proud. I never said thank you for that. Now I never have a chance. May angels lead you in. Here you meet my friends on sleepless roads, the sleepless go. May angels lead you in.
Thank you. What does Remembrance Day mean to you?
Remembrance Day gives me a sense of pride in this country for all those who ultimately sacrificed their lives for our well-being. The history of Canadian soldiers, and especially all the women who served behind the scenes and children, it gives me a sense of Canadian pride that they gave the ultimate sacrifice.
What Remembrance Day means to me is we take a moment of silence to remember the fallen soldiers that helped fight for this country and help develop it into what it is now, and how much better and a bit more open it is than it was before. We have a lot more rights and freedoms and just a lot more joy, and
a day where we honor those who gave their lives quite literally for us. They sacrificed themselves so that we could be free.
To use this day to acknowledge the fallen soldiers who sacrificed their lives to protect our country.
When I think of Remembrance Day, what comes to my mind are all the soldiers who fought and died to ensure the safety of ours and to make a better Canada.
What if we didn't have our human rights?
Well, if we didn't have our human rights, I think we'd be living in chaos.
We would be no different from third world countries. It would be a struggle in society to live in.
To me, basic human rights are, you know, essential for human dignity. I think it's a God-given right for all of us on the planet to have these rights and freedoms.
It'd be a different world altogether, and it'd be a lot more difficult because we wouldn't be able to be who we are. We wouldn't have the human dignity, we wouldn't have our religion, we wouldn't have education, all things that are kind of the cornerstones of what Canada believes in, and it's been thriving because of those rights. If we didn't have them, our world would look a lot different, and it would be a lot more difficult to be who you are.
Which right or freedom is most important to you?
Definitely freedom to express myself, to be able to speak my mind, dress the way that I want to dress without fear of persecution. Also, legal rights, protection under the law. I think it's, although it's flawed at times, it's very important that we're safe within society, that we feel that we can leave our homes, and that everything is going to be okay because we are protected.
The most right that benefits to me would obviously be freedom of speech. Being my age and knowing the intel that I know at this age is a lot on your brain. So just expressing it and saying what you want to say is, I feel, very crucial to growing up in today's era.
Well, they're all important, but I think because we've just come through an election cycle, I really started thinking about the right to vote that we have and how amazing it is that we live in a country where we get to choose the people that are going to lead us. We get to direct our own future by exercising our franchise, by voting, to bring in the people that are going to help uphold our rights and freedoms that are so important. So voting, for me, that's one of the most important rights.
The right to human life. We all have created the image and likeness of God to live and thrive in a society in which we become the best versions of what God intended us to be.
Some people say I'm a fighter, and some people hate what I do, but I stand for my country. They respect what I child you're leaving. Believe me, it's a hard thing to do. So if I die, don't judge me, 'cause I
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. O Lord, look with love upon our men and women in uniform and protect them in their time of need. Give them health and stability and allow them to return to their loved ones whole and unshaken. Thank you for the men and women who serve in our armed forces, who look out for us, and protect our way of life. Lord, please let us never forget the contributions of our armed forces to our daily lives, and Lord, please help us to always remember. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Saint Marcellinus, pray for us.